Thank you very much. So a presentation on the challenges of digital government to Ireland. Thankfully, I'm not the first person to mention the B word this morning. But one of the things that's not really talked about when we talk about Brexit is the impact that it will have on digital and specifically Ireland's digital agenda. When the UK leave, not only will Ireland be even more peripatetic to mainland Europe, and it's good to see Iceland here, actually makes us feel a little bit better, but also we are then the only part of the EU which relies on common law, and we're part of the EU which has very similar views on certain things to the UK, but slightly different to the rest of Europe. But the geographic break is actually difficult for us because Tonis mentioned in his presentation about the natural cross-border work that's taken place with things like eIDAS and so on. What you hear, obviously, in our news is the UK Prime Minister talking about technology to minimise inconvenience between two countries that sit side by side, whereas in the rest of Europe, they're talking about the free flow of data, finance, trade, people, and so on. So this is a challenge for us about how we use technology to take that geographic space away and become more integrated into Europe. Roland's mentioned the DESI index. Ireland is one of the countries in Europe which would be seen to be so far not fully exploiting e-government. And I guess the reason for that is that technology is just an infrastructure like many other infrastructures. And just like we underinvested in those infrastructures in the era post the crash, and we're trying to catch up now, technology is no different. And so this shows that Ireland has an awful lot of work to do in terms of digital government if we're going to be one of Europe's leaders in this area. This is a model actually which is replicated in the global space as well, where Ireland would be seen as a country where globally is in a very good position, but not investing and moving forward at the rate of some of the other countries in the world. And the two areas where we fall down specifically is, if you look at that map, it's hard to read, but in the 7 o'clock position, you see public service, and in the 11 o'clock position, you see talent development. So in some respects, the fantastic relationship we have with the digital multinationals has been good for the economy in many respects, but it's also inhibited the growth of our indigenous business, and that's something that we need to develop and put right. A couple of the initiatives that Roland and Tonis referred to were the eIDAS regulation and the single digital gateway. And the purpose behind this is this idea that we can treat Europe almost as one super state, and that someone in France, for example, could buy a house in Ireland just as easily as someone in Ireland can. And that's because we're recognising other states' digital credentials. But obviously, if we're going to do that, we need to build that same culture in Ireland itself. And our public service ICT strategy, which was produced about 3 years ago, recognises that there's things we need to do to get our own house in order if we're going to integrate more fully into Europe. Our strategy is not that different to most other governments in the world. It's about giving people access to digital services using their device of choosing and at the time and place of their choosing. To do that, we need a joined up digital service. To do that, we need to join up our data in the background. We need to have more shared platforms to do that. We need to increase our capability, not just of ourselves, the people developing the systems, but also the people using the systems at a business level and using the citizens, in fact, within the state, our citizens themselves. And we need the governance and legislation to permit that. So how are we doing? Well, we now have a single portal in place that you can access all government online services. And we have in our eID, the MyGovID, which has just gone through the 400,000th barrier, which in 3 years, 3 years ago, it was less than 10,000. So the public are really showing they understand this agenda and they support it. We are working with various bodies like Ipsos and Trinity Business School to really bring an external view of our digital services and how these need to improve. And it's interesting, the Trinity Business School example, for example, we're using masters in digital marketing, people who are 80% non-Indigenous. We're giving them life events like coming to work in Ireland, getting married in Ireland, buying a house in Ireland, and they're testing these digitally and telling us their experiences, good, bad, and indifferent, and we're using those to actually drive change. On the data front, we've now our Data Sharing and Governance Act, which was agreed in March and signed off by the President. And we've got a data strategy where we can move much more from little single holdings of data to registers of data and align with the EU principle of tell us once, use many times, which is a big thing across Europe and needs to be a big thing in Ireland. The people should only have to give us common details like name, address, date of birth and so on once, and then give us the permission that we can use that to basically pre-fill forms for them when they come on to use another government service, or indeed tell them things they're entitled to that they may well not otherwise know about. So we're starting to start to build towards a hybrid model of government cloud and private cloud. We have initiatives in place to strengthen our own capability at all levels. And we've got governance structures now in place which not only affect central government, but also the big sectoral areas like health, like local government, like education and justice, and start to get this much more cohesive approach to delivering a better digital experience to the citizens and businesses of Ireland. One area where I mentioned earlier we saw that we really could do more was strengthening our Indigenous capability. And it was very interesting to see Adrian talk about the Ludgate hub. It's one, a model I know very well. But the lesson in that is that the most agile, sometimes the parts of the country with most ability are actually our startup community. And Ed mentioned earlier on about we produce some of the best cybersecurity specialists in the world. We actually produce people of outstanding skills in many facets of digital and ICT. Government needs to be engaging those people faster and using their talents rather than simply always going back to the multinationals who sometimes have less ability in specific areas, especially in disruptive technologies, and don't have that same agility. So one of the things about our GovTech initiative is how we're going to use emerging technologies to better serve the people of Ireland. We want to not just be the best place in Europe to transact digitally with government, but actually be the best place in Europe to be part of a tech startup. And we had a fantastic session in June with various people from academia, from startups, from the universities and so on. And we came up with a number of key summary actions which are being taken to government by the Minister of State. The first of those is to reuse government assets. And another area where Ireland is slightly different is in the rest of Europe, they have no problem with using your state-given EID to use other services like banking, like insurance and so on. That seems to be a challenge for us in Ireland, but we need to break that cultural barrier, because if we're going to have more and more people from Europe coming in to live and work in the country, they're going to expect these services to be provided. We need to review our government funding framework. The view was government is actually very generous to startups. They just don't always know how to get access to that money. We need to have a more cohesive digital talent development model, and that needs to stretch the whole way across the country. One of the big things about tech is people shouldn't have to come to Dublin to get good jobs. They should be able to work and live where they want. And the National Broadband Plan, which the Minister talked about earlier, is a way to actually make this a smaller country. We don't want people having to drive 4 hours or take a train for 4 hours to come to work when they can work quite happily in their own communities. We need a procurement model to get faster access to startups. And we need government to be an exemplar. One of the findings of OECD and others is healthy digital government spaces tend to be healthy digital economy. So where if government gets better at digital services, this will have a positive impact in GDP. We need to use our GovTech to drive inclusivity, so not just regional, but letting all parts of business and all parts of our talent participate in this revolution. And one of the things that I'm most proud of is we've just had 34 ICT apprenticeships passing out, all of whom are going to work directly to government. That's the type of model that we should be looking at, where we're taking people who maybe weren't given the best careers advice at school, giving them a second chance, aptitude testing them, and now we're training them, and we will enable them to get degrees and master degrees in digital and technology within government. And finally, we need the governance right for the GovTech model, and we need a branding model for that. So that's a very quick run through what we're trying to do in Ireland to take ourselves to be much more integrated in the initiatives happening in Europe, and also to be one of the leaders in Europe in terms of helping Europe to compete globally in the tech industry. Thank you very much. Thank you.